This course uses the Java computer programming language. People talk a lot about which programming language is the best to teach beginning programmers, sometimes with the strength of conviction that's usually reserved for discussions of religion and politics. And just like discussions of religion and politics, the conversation can create more heat than light. Java has some good things going for it. First, it's platform independent. This means that we can take the same program and run it on a PC and on a Mac. That's great for this class because it means that different students can write the same program on their own preferred computer without special problems coming up. Java is also from the family of object-oriented programming languages. Lots of programming languages that are used commercially are object-oriented, so learning Java makes it easier to learn these other languages. Examples of other object-oriented languages include C++, C#, Objective-C, and Ruby. Java is a modern programming language. It was designed when it was clear that languages would have to deal with some surprisingly tough problems, like security, creating graphical user interfaces on many different computer platforms, and using multiple languages, including pictographic languages like Mandarin and languages that are organized differently from English. Java also allows programs to be multi-threaded. A thread is a sequence of operations. When you have a multi-threaded program, the program can be doing many different sequences of operations at the same time. You've probably seen this in programs, although you may not have known what to call it. For example, when you use an email program, you can usually write one email for a while, then read other emails and bounce back and forth. Each email has its own thread. This is a great thing to be able to do with your programs, and Java makes it relatively easy. Java also has an advanced feature called reflection that's really cool, although it's a bit beyond the scope of this discussion. One of the nicest things about Java is that it has a wonderful and rich library of resources available. This is called the Application Programmer's Interface, or API. Best of all, the API is well documented with beautifully designed web pages that describe what's available. It takes practice to learn how to use these powerful tools, but the practice pays off with being able to do more interesting and fun programs sooner. If you keep programming, you'll learn lots of languages. Every language you learn makes learning the next language a little easier. I program in about 20 languages now and can learn a new language in just a few days. You'll be able to do the same in time if you want to. Some languages make it harder to learn programming. For example, I think it's harder to learn languages like C and C++, because success in these languages depends upon a detailed understanding of how computer memory works. Since most students who are starting to program don't know much about computer hardware, this makes it harder to learn to program. So I don't like teaching beginning programmers C or C++, even though they're two of my favorite languages to use and should be part of any computing professional's toolkit. Here's my take on the big programming language debate. Don't get too worried about whether Java is the perfect language for a beginner or not. I can teach somebody to be a good programmer in almost any language. So relax and enjoy Java.